Hello everyone, Calico Divine here, playing Pro Cycling Manager 2016. We are in Vuelta a España. Stage 10 is about to start. It is the first mountain stage. We can see we are in 7th place for the general classification, 2nd place for the point standings. No, that's the mountain standings. We are in second, but we are in second place for the point standing as well. We will be riding in the green jersey on this stage. We are in a big lead for the under 25 jersey, so that's very nice. Hopefully we will be able to have a good stage here. Stage 10, I'm expecting National Bing to be pulling the peloton along here, and the breakaway should get at least a decent lead. And then they will be caught on the final climb. You see, it is National being doing the work here. First mountain stage. It's not a very tough mountain stage because it's mostly small hills until this climb comes in towards the end, and then the final climb. Okay, going into the final climb, stage 10, and the breakaway got a big lead, so I'm pretty sure they're going to hold. At least if they have a decent climber among them. I haven't looked at that yet. I don't think it really matters for us anyway. We just need to keep an eye on these National Bing riders. Froome in the leader jersey. The leader jersey is red here in Vuelta. Seems like the tempo is not that high at the moment. That's good for us. 7.5 kilometers left for the peloton. A lot of riders still able to hold on here. And yeah, the breakaway is way too far ahead of us. That's bad. If we place well, we wanted to get some points for the points jersey. But it's also good if we place poorly, then we will not lose that much. 5 kilometers left to go for us. Let's see if we can just speed up the game a little bit. There we see it, Daniel Tekle Halmanot. Guess that is Eritrea or something like that. Not really sure if on the flag. We can see people are trying to attack here, and we need to make sure that we are keeping our position. Come on, move closer, catch up. And we are placing very poorly, but at least we should not be losing that much. And top 20. Oh, we are in 20th place. I guess we will need to accept that. We're not in a good position when the tempo got higher and then we lost a bit. Maybe we should have paid more attention in the final climb there, but that can easily happen. So just a short summary of stage 10. The breakaway held. Three people in the breakaway managed to stay away, and we can see that Chris Froome was 10 minutes behind, and he managed to get a small gap together with Daniel Martin, and I think Anthony De La Place was also in the breakaway. Quite sure of that actually. So four people managed to hold in the breakaway, even if De La Place lost a little bit. Chris Froome gained a little time on us as well. Doesn't really matter because we are still so far behind. Points jersey still holding. Mountain jersey. We can see that there people are starting to get more points now. And we are still holding the under 25 jersey. Vuelta is really cruel to us, I think. Another pretty flat stage. Just some ups and downs going on here, and then the end, super tough, very steep climb it seems like. So we need to try and hold on till the end, and we usually struggle with these kind of final climbs, but maybe with a bit of luck we can hold on today, or maybe even attack a bit early to get a head start into the climb. Still 25 kilometers left to go, but my team have been doing most of the work here without me telling them. So I guess they are expecting something big today, since they decided to pull the peloton ahead. We can see the breakaway is almost caught. They are 1 minute ahead, but the gap is shrinking all the time, and with the final climb, it's going to be gone in very, very fast. I guess I have the pressure on me now. Let's see if we can make sure we have a good position. Who is going to help me in the climb? We have Vakosh helping me now. That means we can maybe put Ferrau at pulling the peloton for a little bit when the climb starts. Let's see what happens. I would actually like that if he could start setting a pace, and then maybe I could attack. There we go, the final climb is starting just as we catch up with the breakaway. I wanted Ferrau to be up there, but it is Ponsi setting the pace together with Katusha. Katusha have been working hard most of the climbs. I'm gonna go to 90 effort here. Vakosh is pulling me very good at the moment. Have a great position here, but then I lost some speed because I got caught, so I'm gonna set my own pace here. And I am in front of the pack now. How are they doing behind me? They are going to let me go. They are going to let me go here, so I'm gonna use that energy bar to good use. I'm getting a lead here. I'm actually pulling ahead. I have 1 minute. I have 1 minute and 2.5 kilometers left to go. I am crushing them. I am absolutely crushing them. Okay, it must be the race day conditioning. It's just doing miracles on my rider. Going to start the sprint as soon as I possibly can. Come on, guy. Keep the distance. Do not let them catch up anymore. Come on, hold it together. I'm gonna win the stage, but just a question of how much will I win with? The finish line is there. Good job, good job. Raise your arms up in the air. And we can see Froome is not going to get second place today, I think. No, Daniel Martin have been showing he can be strong as well. Tim Wellens, Chris Froome. This was a great victory. The third stage victory so far in this Vuelta a España. We have selected the following highlights. Me passing the goal line. Let's look at the podium. Third time. Very, very nice. I was thinking we could skip it, but it's become a bit of a tradition now to show the big stage wins. 42 seconds, that's excellent. Plus the stage win bonus. Very, very good. We are in the middle of stage 12. It's a hilly stage, but I think with the final climbs looking like this, we might have a chance to do something. Two very tough climbs, or it's the same climb done twice. It looks rather tough, and even if it's quite a bit from the goal line today, I think that is when we need to make our move. Maybe not on the first one, but on the second one. That is where I think we will be able to create some distance between us and the peloton. Not sure if we can win, but we should be able to get a good finish. are almost at the final climb. I have Thoreau still helping me, so that's good. I need to make sure my effort is high. And we need to see if we can get a better position here. Can we move up a little bit? Come on. There we go. There we go. Ah! I wanted to set the pace here, but it didn't let me. Can I move past this National Bean guys? Oh, they are riding really fast. Even if with 90 effort, it's still a struggle here. There we go, I am in the front and they are going to let me go for a little bit here. We can see some of them are trying to chase Valverde, Chris Froome among them. Now it's just downhill to the finish line. I hope I have enough energy left. I'm gonna go to 82 effort and I have a small lead over 10 or something riders. 6 kilometers left to go. Vakos, one of my helpers, crashed. Should not matter. Hopefully he can continue. 4 kilometers left and I'm almost dead. I am almost dead. I'm gonna use the energy bar and then I'm gonna wait for the sprint. There we go. Sprint, sprint, sprint. I'm gonna win the stage. I'm gonna win the stage. I'm out of strength, but I do not think they will be able to pass me. Nope. Actually, I'm still pulling ahead a bit. I am still pulling ahead a bit. If I can win with over 1 minute, that would be absolutely excellent. This is a big win. This is a big, big win. You can see Daniel Martin. Michael Matthews. Oh, I think it would be Daniel Martin. This is a huge win. And now for the best moments of the day. Me coming around the last bend. And that is the finish line. Yes, I was just about to raise my arms there, but we can see the podium is there. Waving to the audience, taking my prizes from the girls. You see 1 minute and 6 seconds. That is excellent. We got second stage in a row. A big win, and we are now in fourth place in the general classification. We are 2 minutes and 37 seconds behind Chris Froome. But I feel like we might be able to pass Daniel Martin very soon. Did we take this jersey? No, we are 3 points behind Chris Froome, but we are very close to taking it. Mountain jersey, we did not get any points for that final climb. And we are pretty much already the winner of this jersey as long as we can make it through all 21 stages. Next episode, we're gonna take on 3 of the toughest stages in the Vuelta this year, this season. First a hilly stage and then 2 mountain stages. So that will be very interesting if we can continue with this excellent form we are having at the moment. We seem to be the strongest. Then those 3 stages might be very interesting to see. Until then, I'm Killer Cow Divine and thank you all for watching.